Hello guys, welcome to this Java tutorial for beginners. In our today's video, we will talk about local variables in Java. So without wasting time, let's get started. Now let us understand local variables with the help of this program. So in our class A, we have this instance variable, and you can tell that this is an instance variable because it is contained inside the class and it does not contain any static keyword. And below that we have a static variable also called as class variable, right? And it contains the static keyword, right? And now after that we have this print method, and inside the print method we have a variable and we call this as a local variable. So local variable is nothing but a variable that is declared inside the method, all right? And now what I will do is I'll simply try to compile this program. So let me compile the program, and as you can see, we did not get any compilation errors. All right. Now in the program, what I have done is I have simply created this print1 method, and what it does is it simply prints the instance variable and the class variable, right? And inside a print method, what I do is I simply print the local variable. Okay. So now let me compile the program once again. And you must note one thing, that I have not initialized the variables, nor the instance class or the local variable. All right. So now let me compile the program. Now let me try to compile the program. And as you see, we have the compilation error. Variable, local variable might not have been initialized. All right. So now let us fix the compilation error, and you know, let us initialize the local variable with the value of 1, right? And now let me save this and run this program once again. But before that, let me call the print and the print1 method. So I'll call this print method and the print1 method. So it's print1. Okay, so now let me run this program. Now let me compile and execute the program. So let me run it. And as you see, we have the output as local variable 1, instance variable 0, and class variable 0. Now, let us just talk about the local variable. So let me clear this statements, right? So let me clear this method as well, right? So first thing you must have noticed is that, you know, whenever we want to use the local variable, then we need to initialize it. Otherwise, we'll get the compilation error, right? And this is not the case with the instance variable and the static variable, right? Let me clear this statement as well, as we no longer have the print1 method. Next thing what you need to remember about local variables is that you cannot apply access modifier to the local variables. So if I try to write something like this, public int local variable, then I'll get the compilation error. So let me show you this. Now let me compile the program, and as you see, we have the compilation error, illegal start of expression. Third thing that you need to remember is that you cannot use static keyword with the local variable. If you try to use this, then you'll get the compilation error. Next thing that you need to know is that you can use the final keyword with the local variable. That is, you can make this local variable a constant, and if you try to reassign the value, then you will get the compilation error. Otherwise, the program will run successfully. So let me run this program now. Now let us compile the program, and as you see, we do not have any compilation error. So let me run this, and here we have the output as local variable 1. And one final thing that you need to know about your local variables is that your local variable cannot be accessed outside the body of your method, right? So, you know, if I try to do something like this, you know, I have this print1 method, and now if I try to access the local variable in a print1 method, then I'll get the compilation error, right? So, you know, let me try to compile this program. Now, let me compile the program, and we should have the compilation error. So we can see that we have the compilation error, cannot find symbol. All right. And the variables that accept values in the method signature are called as method parameters. and the rules of your local variable apply to the method parameters as well. All right.
So that is it for today's video. And don't forget to subscribe for more Java programming videos like this. And I will see you until next time.